Welcome to Tea Time with Maya. I'm Maya, and Mom's behind the camera today.
Hi.
Today we are going to do ginger tea infused with lemon, which for most of us suffering from allergies during the season, this video will be very great for you. and so today we have the Le Creuset. What is this called?
It's the sauce pot.
The sauce pot. I knew that. Like I just knew that because I know all the names of them. Clearly, yeah. This is the sauce pot. It has water inside from where Mom put it. I'm scared of the tops. And there's water in it. So you put like enough water because we're going to put it inside of this mesh.
What are we putting in the mesh?
We're gonna put the what do they call it? The herbs at the time. They're all herbs, so we're gonna call them herbs as they are.
The ginger and the lemon.
Yeah, the ginger and lemon. Yeah, of course. It's okay. I'm nervous when I'm by myself. Okay, so you put the mesh inside. Okay, so we'll talk about what lemon does in another time in another video, but today we're going to talk about the properties.
And make sure you add enough water so that when your strainer goes in, your
tea is able to move. Because what's going to happen is we're going to put this on the stove, and the stove's going to boil it, so the water's going to start moving. But if there's no water inside of your mesh, it's not going. The herbs or whatever you put in the mesh is not going to change the water. It's not going to become tea. It's just going to be water that tastes vaguely like whatever you put in the mesh. I know that from experience. But I don't know if I just said that as well. I don't know if you're cutting it. Well, today we're going to do ginger. The lemon we'll do at another video. I think I said that, but it's okay.
We're just using it to infuse the ginger today.
One thing that ginger does do that most people know with ginger ale or ginger beer is it relieves nausea. And the tea does the exact same things. So like if someone gets on a plane and they don't feel very well, the flight attendant will usually give them ginger ale. And just regular ginger inside of the tea will do the exact same thing. So if you feel nauseous, the first moment you feel nauseous, have some ginger tea and it will relieve it.
Well, we're not doing it.
See, that's the problem because you're always like, oh, help, but no, we're not doing that tea right now. And another thing that it does, which is great for this time of the season, is it relieves like congestion. So it's commonly also found in like cough drops and stuff. So it helps relieve your throat, like coating your throat so that you don't feel so like you can't breathe or can't clear your throat because it's sore. It helps stop that. And the last thing is...
Well, it helps soothe.
Yeah, it helps soothe, sorry. I don't know what I just said. Another thing it does for indigestion is when it goes down the body, it helps calm the small intestine because sometimes when your stomach has like a lot of air in it, your small intestines will start like cramping and it will hurt and you feel bloating. It goes through and it helps to calm. Mint tea also does that, but we're not doing mint right now. it helps calm. And when it calms, the cramping goes down, which is something that commonly happens during your menstrual cycle for females. For men, I'm sorry. it will help calm so that your cramps aren't so bad or so prominent. Is that the word? Yeah, prominent. And so it helps, yeah. I'm gonna stop saying calm.
How does ginger tea help you? What do you use it for?
I use ginger tea when I feel like I have like the common cold going on or someone sneezes near me and then I'm like, drink tea, tea, tea. I sometimes, when we have available, I will use like, this is ginger root. It looks very weird and like kind of deformed, but this is what ginger looks like. It's a root. And if you want ginger, it's much cheaper to buy the root versus the whole thing of ginger tea. You just
the tea from the store.
Yeah, the tea from the store, because the tea from the store will give you like 10 sachets. Yeah, we're gonna pretend that didn't happen. but this, you just can keep cutting it.
How do you preserve it?
What you do is you cut it, and then you take a napkin, like a napkin or a paper napkin. We don't have any in our house for some reason. And you will just dab it here until it is no longer wet to the touch. And you want to do that because if the root stays wet and you put it back in the refrigerator, it can mold. And then you have to cut that part off. Because when it molds, it doesn't mold the whole thing. It's molded in one area and it looks like horrible. But you just cut that off if that happens. But if you don't want it to happen at all, you pat it dry.
And we tend to keep ours out on the counter.
Yes, because it's hot now because of summertime and it stays.
And it doesn't hang around that long.
Yeah, that's true. We accidentally buy two sometimes. That has nothing to do with anything. Do it like that. We forget that it's sitting on the counter. We just go buy another one. You can commonly buy these in Target, Walmart, any like major grocery store.
To get the bigger one though, go to
like a global market, like a global Asian market or a Spice Bazaar, I think.
Go to a global market.
Yeah, they will have ginger.
Or the farmer's market.
It's true too. Sometimes
three. Or grow your own.
We haven't tried that yet, so we'll get back to you if that actually works. that's what you would do. But if you just have the regular ginger sachets, you would just put it in hot water. Depending on the size of your pot, depends on how long you would boil it. For a pot about this size, it would probably be about 3 minutes to reach a boil. But if you had like a bigger size, maybe add additional 2 minutes for each growing size of pot. And you just put it on the stove, and you don't put a top on this because you want the steam to go, and it will also make your house smell amazing. And then you just let it boil. After you finish boiling your water, you will let it steep on the counter off of heat for about 5 to 10 minutes, or until it reaches the strength of whatever you boiled in it. So for ginger, maybe about 5 to 10 minutes until it's like really strong and flavored. It tastes exactly like ginger.
Just kind of knock you out.
Yeah, and the stronger it is, the better you're gonna get results. And I like to.
It'll just be really spicy.
Don't let it sit too long. I've done that before and it tastes like ginger beer, and I was like, I don't know what I did, but I don't think we should drink this anymore. Ginger beer is brew, by the way. It's not alcohol. I'm just going to fix that. Before someone's like, you don't look old enough. So with this, I like to use brown sugar or honey. You can use white sugar, but I found that it makes it like a little too sweet for me. But for most herbal remedies, brown sugar and honey or molasses for some people, I don't understand that.
Or none at all.
That's true. This can stand on its own. You don't actually need to have any sugar in it, but some people like to have sugar or sweetener. And that's pretty much it for today.
So we're going to let it boil and then...
We'll let it boil and we'll let you see what I mean by a honey color. And if it doesn't come to one, then we're going to just pretend I never said that. So we'll be right back. Hi guys, we've steeped the tea and I put the top on it so that the steam could rise up and our tea wouldn't get cold as it was steeping. And so as I lift it up, you can see all the steam. I don't know how good the camera is so that you can see it. It didn't turn honey colored. It's pretty, but we added lemon to it, so it kind of diluted type of the color.
No, but there is a color to it, Maya.
Look. But it's supposed to be the color of honey. That's not the color of honey.
That is a light color honey, yes.
Yeah, honey look like that, girl. Okay, so I'm going to get a mug so I can show you what it looks like in the cup. You just put your ladle down and you pick up the liquid.
Normally we just pour it into the cup.
From the pot.
But these pots don't have
a lip.
They don't have anything to pour
with. Yeah, but you can just pour it. It's not going to do anything, but I get it.
I would recommend, if you pick up a Le Creuset pot, I would recommend using a handle.
Or just pour it into a,
I'm trying to show them what color it is.
Pitcher.
Oh, yes.
See, it does.
It looks more like lemonade.
No, it does not.
It doesn't taste like lemonade.
No, it will not. Okay. We're just going to put it down on our counter so you can clearly see the contrast of color. And that is your ginger tea.
For looks, you can just add a piece of ginger.
And if we definitely can grab that, we can't. Oh no, it's falling. That's how we make tea, and wow, it is dark. Yeah, the lemon just disappeared. Okay, so this is how you make the ginger lemon-infused tea, and I hope you like the video. Comment below what other herb you would like, Madison, if you want to put my tea down. Comment what other tea you would like us to do, and we'll put those on the, sorry.
On the routine. We already have a list of teas that
we're... Why did you say I? Because you are the tea person.
Well, I already have like a list of teas that I already know a lot about, so I was planning to do those. But if you have any ideas or things that you want to know more about, you can post those below. And please tell me if you like this channel, because...
Or unlike the video.
No, no. This segment. Because I had to beg for this. And the more you say Maya rocks, the more I get more channels.
So, or more
segments. Okay. Yeah. So... Please like, share, and subscribe, and thanks for watching!